heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strains.
Angels we have heard on high, singing sweetly through the night, and the mountains in reply, echoing their brave delight.
Chelsea's day, oh, Gloria, in Chelsea's day.
Well, I know that normally you're expecting me to ask you to turn to Ecclesiastes, and we're going to follow what Koheleth has to say, but because this is a Sunday before Christmas, I'm going to detour a little bit. And so if you have your Bible, I'm going to invite you to turn to Luke chapter 2, and we're going to look at verses 1 through 7, just to kind of put us in the Christmas mood as we move towards this special holiday. So most of us know the Christmas story. I mean, basically, we can look at first chapter of Matthew and look at first chapter of Luke and second chapter of Luke, and we can almost recite exactly what the Christmas story is. So it's not like I'm bringing you anything new today, but just a reminder of the fact that this holiday is something special. Now, once again, we don't know exactly the date in which Jesus was born. We don't know what time of the year necessarily, but we do know that Jesus was born of a woman, of a virgin, Mary, and that he did actually live. All the historians say that there was an individual named Jesus who lived during a time frame that the Bible actually says. And so we want to celebrate his birth. So here in Luke chapter 2, verse 1, it says this. Dr. Luke wrote this down for us. Now, in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that a census be taken in all the inhabited world. Now, this was the first census taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone was on his way to register for the census, each to his own city. So Caesar Augustus had made this decree that there's going to be this census, and he wanted to make sure that everybody went back to their hometown, that is the town of their ancestors, and so that he could get a proper idea of how many people did exist and where people actually were from. And so, of course, this was the Roman Empire. The Roman Empire took over a number of different regions, a number of different tribes, and they all reported up under Rome. And so Caesar Augustus just really wants to know exactly where everybody is from, and also how many people are in his empire. And so it's just kind of interesting as we think about this, right? Joseph and Mary were in Nazareth, that is in northern Israel, and so they had to come south to Bethlehem to be able to be counted, because that is where Joseph's family was from. And so they had to make this journey, make this trek to Bethlehem. It's interesting too, if we were to be alive during that time, we would see that, man, it was a very busy time. It was a lot of stuff going on. Matter of fact, it was somewhat chaotic as people were traveling across the region. Some people going north, some people going south, some people going east, some people going west. I mean, there was a lot of chaos going on because everybody was trying to get back to their hometown. And so it just reminds me really of our day and time, not necessarily because of travel, because right now in COVID-19, people are not really traveling, but it does remind me that it was a chaotic time. And I can say that we do live in a chaotic time. And because they lived in a chaotic time, right, they were not thinking about the birth of Jesus. Now, of course, they did not have the New Testament and they didn't know that Jesus was necessarily coming, but they should have, at least Jews, should have been looking forward to the coming of Jesus Christ, just like we as Christians should be looking forward to the coming of Jesus Christ. That is his second Advent. And so I was just thinking about that, you know, how chaotic it is and how we live in a chaotic world right now, chaotic time. I was this past Wednesday, I went down, and of course, you know that Moody Theological Seminary is in Plymouth, Michigan, and sometimes I go to downtown Plymouth just to get me something to eat. And last Wednesday, I went down there, and normally around this time, there's all type of Christmas decorations, there are all type of lights, there are all this type of thing. But because everything seems to be shut down, and downtown Plymouth is filled with a number of small businesses, and of course these small businesses aren't able to do operations the way they normally do, they have to limit the amount of people that they have in there. These restaurants have to make sure that it's all carry out. I mean, it's just such a different atmosphere. And so we, just like them, are dealing in a chaotic time that is taking place during the time of Jesus, and of course, of the birth of Jesus. And of course, these individuals are not looking for Jesus coming. I just want to say this because it seems like this year, there's not this real excitement about Christmas, right? Because there's so many other things that are going on, whether we're still trying to figure out the election, where there's still some things in the back with regard to racial reconciliation, that type of thing. And of course, we got COVID on the brain. Everything, COVID seems to affect everything. And so just like in Jesus' day, I mean, in his birth, time of his birth, people were not looking to Jesus being born. It's almost like we aren't even looking forward to Christmas. It's just kind of like, okay, it's going to happen this year, but you know, there's not really this all excitement about it. So there's a lot of parallels. Verse 4, it says, Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and the family of David, in order to register along with Mary, who was engaged to him. Now, we already said that Joseph and Mary had to make this trek, right, from Nazareth, which was in Galilee, down to Judea, where they were in Bethlehem, come back to where his ancestors are, so he could be counted with his extended family. But the interesting thing is, if we look earlier, the whole world was chaotic, but sometimes we forget that maybe Joseph and Mary's life was chaotic too, because they were living in northern Israel. That was their home. That's where they resided. And now, because of the census, they have to pack up and they have to leave. And here it is that Mary is with child, and they have to travel all these miles to Bethlehem. And we know already that they don't have a place to stay. They don't have a place to stay. We're going to see that a little later, but that's why they had to go into the barn to be able to have Jesus, or to give birth to Jesus. So their life is chaotic too. A number of us find not only is the world chaotic right now, but also our lives have been turned upside down. A number of us have had sicknesses in our life this past year. I think about my mom and dad both getting COVID, and dad having to go into Henry Ford Hospital for 8 days and be on oxygen for over a month, and not knowing whether he's going to make it or not while he's in the hospital, and couldn't really talk to him because nobody knew what COVID was about, and the hospital was overwhelmed. And many of you lost loved ones, lost parents, lost siblings, lost cousins, lost friends. We live in a chaotic world, but also that chaos has hit our life as well. And so what happens then? Because of these chaotic things that have happened, we might not want to celebrate Christmas as much as well. But we have to. We have to, in this sense, that God sent His Son, His one and only Son, His unique Son, His one of a kind Son, so that He might live a perfect life, so that we might have everlasting life through His death. So whether we celebrate it on December 25th, or we celebrate it any day of the year, we still need to celebrate the birth of Jesus, because His coming gave us the beginning of new life. And so we see that right here. I just want to say this too. It also affects our Christmas, doesn't it? It affects our Christmas. COVID-19 affects everything. It affects our Christmas. It affects our work life. It affects everything. Matter of fact, this past week, we have a number of students that are graduating in December. That is, students in Michigan and also in Chicago, and also all around the globe, because they are taking classes online. So this past Saturday, we had like a 2-hour virtual graduation. I've never been part of a virtual graduation, but there I was online, all these other professors online, all these administrators online, and all these students online. And I got to tell you, it did not, you know, even though the background screen said congratulations and had all this confetti, and each graduate had a background behind them that said something about finally finished and all that, it still didn't feel right. COVID-19 has hit everything, and it's hit our lives. And what was going on in Mary and Joseph's day with the whole census affected their lives just as well. So we come to Christmas, and we come to Christmas in a time, man, it just seems chaotic. It seems like it's not right. Seems like our life has been upended. But God is still in the midst of it. Matter of fact, here we go right here in verse 5, the last part of verse 5. Verse 5, the end of it says this, and Mary also, right? And Mary was with child. While they were there, the days were completed for her to give birth, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. Now, it doesn't say how long Joseph and Mary were in Bethlehem. It doesn't say that. It's not like they got there on a Sunday morning, and by Sunday evening, you know, here come baby Jesus. It doesn't say that. It doesn't tell us how long they were there. But they were there, and she was expecting sometime soon. Now, what is interesting is she comes here, and Joseph comes here, and there's absolutely no place for them to stay. That is mind-boggling, and people are not looking for Jesus to be born. For me, that's the biggest thing right there. How is it that they are not looking for Jesus to be born? I mean, the wise men who live some 600 miles away, they saw the star, they knew Jesus had been born, they began their trekking to figure out what was going on, but the individuals that were right there were not looking for Jesus. Matter of fact, you remember what the wise man, the scholars in Israel, in Jerusalem, you remember the scripture that they went to when Herod was like, hey, where is this Messiah going to be born? Turn with me right quick, if you have your Bible, to Micah 5:2. Micah chapter 5, verse 2, right? And it says right here in Micah chapter 5, verse 2. But as for you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, too little to be among the clans of Judah, for you will go forth for me to be a ruler in Israel. His goings forth are from long ago, from the days of eternity. They knew where the Messiah was going to be born. There was a star that indicated that Jesus had arrived, but nobody was looking for him. That's the amazing thing to me. But it was because in the midst of misery and complexity, nobody was looking for God's son. I want to say right now, you know, we live in a time of misery and complexity. I've already mentioned the three things, right? The whole election thing and all those dynamics, the racial tension, and then COVID-19. We live in a time of misery and complexity. But in the midst of misery and complexity in that day, God showed up for all who were looking for him. It's the same way today. We can still see God in the midst of this. We can still rejoice in the Christmas season because God is here. It doesn't matter how complex and how miserable situations are. If we look for God, we will find him. You know, normally this time of the year, the news programs do all these wonderful stories, right? They do these wonderful stories of a mom or a dad who is serving overseas in the military, coming home and surprising their spouse or surprising their kids. You know, sometimes they show up at school, sometimes they show up at work, sometimes they show up at an event. But the family is going on about their business, thinking that they're not going to have their dad or their mom home, or their wife or their husband home for Christmas. And then all of a sudden, right, all of a sudden they go behind something or they turn a corner or whatever. And there he or she is in the midst of a situation where they don't even think that God, that their husband or their wife is going to show up. There he or she is. The interesting thing about that is, right, they're never looking for him. But with God, those who are looking for him will find him in the midst of the complexity, the misery, and the chaos. We will find God, we will find Jesus in the midst of this holiday season if we look for him. And we can ask God, help us to see the joy of Jesus' birth. Help us to be able to just be excited about what was going on, even though we might not be able to express it the same way we have in the past. Help us to rejoice even in the midst of adversity. You know, it reminds me of Philippians chapter 4, right? And Philippians chapter 3 as well. Rejoice always. Always rejoice in the Lord. No matter what is going on or whatever situation, we can still find reasons to rejoice in him. And this is a great reason. Christmas is a great reason to rejoice in God. Now, in the verse seven, I bring this to a close now. It says, and she, that is Mary, wrapped him, that is Jesus, in cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. So here it is. Here it is. She may have even been not expecting Jesus to arrive so soon. Nowhere in scripture does it say that she carried Jesus for 9 months. Don't say that. It just says when the time came, Jesus was born. So Jesus may have shown up unexpectedly. And so all we got now is a few little rags around here to wrap this baby in, because we weren't planning on this happening while we were here. We thought we had enough time to come down here to Bethlehem, be counted, and go on back up to Nazareth, and things would be good. But no, because God was going to fulfill his prophecy, which was in Micah 5:2, when they hit the city limits, the town limits of Bethlehem, God started to clock. And so now here they are, they're trying to find a place to say, now this is interesting too, right? Because they had to come to the place where their ancestors were from, which means you would think, man, they got cousins, they got aunts, they got uncles, they got brothers, they got people in Bethlehem that could house them. But when they come, nobody got a place for them. Nobody got a room for them. They got to go to the inn, and then the inn is full because of all these travelers. In other words, by the time Joseph and Mary showed up in Bethlehem, every relative had somebody filling their house. I'm sorry, Joseph. I'm sorry, Mary. You know, there's no place for you. Think about this for a minute. You show up with your fiance, she with child, and y'all can't find a place. There is no relative, no cousin, no uncle, no distant relative that will house you. In other words, one of two things could have took place. One is, because Joseph was not married to Mary, maybe there was a stigma that they didn't want them staying with them. That's one thing. Number two could be that because Mary may not have been 9 months pregnant, they didn't realize the condition which she was in. And so they're not going to try and make room, because it's hard for me to imagine that if there is a woman that is like 9 months pregnant and barely able to walk around, that you can't find a place for her. So evidently this baby coming at this time was unexpected. And she don't even have clothes to wrap the baby in. And even the innkeeper don't have a place. Man, go put the baby in the barn. Y'all can stay there with the animals, with the unclean animals, with the smelly animals, and you can put the baby in the feeding trough. Time for Jesus to be born. The Old Testament prophesies of the moment. The star shines and says, God's son is born. And nobody welcomes him. You know what's interesting about this Christmas? It's a strange Christmas. It's strange. You know, we got these regulations now that say we can't do this, we can't do that, or we gotta do this, or we gotta do that. But that first Christmas was strange too. Because what family member wouldn't welcome their relative in who had a pregnant wife? Family not being able to hang out with family. Sounds like this Christmas. You know, I was talking to one of my coworkers, one of my fellow faculty and young guy, you know, just kind of got into teaching at the seminary, and he was telling me that he had COVID-19 this past summer he got COVID, and it kind of wrecked him a little bit. He lost all sense of smell and sense of taste. The smell came back, but he still doesn't have the full sense of taste that he had beforehand, and he's like, man, he's looking forward to Christmas. And his mama told him, it's funny to me, his mama told him, he ain't coming over for Christmas. No. And he said, Mom, wait a minute, I didn't have COVID. I'm not going to bring COVID over there because I didn't already recovered from it, you know. And Mama's like, no, not this Christmas. Not this Christmas, honey. You know, send me a card. Look at me on Zoom, but you ain't coming over for Christmas. Joseph and Mary probably wanted to visit their relatives on that first Christmas, but they couldn't. But God still showed up. And God still showed out. And God still accomplished His will. This Christmas, brothers and sisters, I don't know what your situation is going to be. I don't know if you're going to have a full house of people, or you're going to limit it to just your core family. I don't know what you're going to do. I don't even know what we're going to do. But this one thing I do know, that if we look for Jesus in the midst of it, we will find Him. Father God, thank You for Your word, just reminding us of that first Christmas. And we paint it very beautiful on cards and on stationery. We tell wonderful stories of it in Hollywood. But the truth is, Your son was born probably unexpectedly. The parents weren't prepared. And the family didn't receive Him. The prophets weren't looking for Him. But yet, You showed up in the midst. We ask that You would show up this Christmas for us. No matter what our situation is, may we see You. And may we be like the shepherds. We will celebrate and we will rejoice because You have come. We ask Your blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining.